Sabadi crap everybody, so far so good. In this episode of my Creative Thoughts series, we are going to open the mold and prepare the slab, turn it into a clock to hang up on the wall. Before jumping to it, if you think I deserve, please subscribe and ring the bell for future videos notification. And now, without any further ado, let's to build some and let's to have fun with! Creative Thought Series Resin Cast Wall Clock. If you are interested in how I ended up to this point, here web links to past episodes. Epoxy is fully cured now. I let it rest for 3 days, and here I am, ready to open the mold. With a chisel and a hammer, I'm going to remove the mold sides. When I build the mold, I cover the sides and bottom with scotch tape, and here you can clearly see how this trick is effective. Epoxy doesn't stick to plastic smooth surfaces, therefore scotch tape is the cheap, proper way to release the piece. With a mild push, the slabs come free. I'm ready to flat the slab with my surface flattening sled. This is a tool that you must have if you are interested in resin cast furnitures, generally speaking. And here a web link to a past video in which I show how I built my sled. With the scrap timber strips, I'm going to screw the slab firmly in place. I'm setting up my plunge router depth to remove no more than 3 mm in a single pass. So, layer by layer, I remove material until a flat, homogeneous surface is achieved. Better to wear some protective glass. I'm turn the slab to the other side, and I'm going to repeat the exact same process. The blue slab is now flat in both sides, and I'm going to repeat the exact same process to the other piece, the green slab, because we are building two resin cast clocks to hang up on the wall. The two clocks are now flat. With a 60 grit paper and my belt sander, I begin to sand the blue clock in both sides, and all the steps shown will be repeated to the second slab, the green clock as well. I turn the slab and I repeat the process, taking my time, and I try to remove all the scratch marks left by the router bits. After a 60 grit paper rough sand, I'm going to straight the clock four edges with my circular saw. My circular saw is armed with a 64 tooth blade that, alongside a precise cut, avoids chipping empty routes. I should be careful in particular to the epoxy part of the clock. As you can notice, I'm executing the cut in two passes. Again, the precautions is to avoid chipping and tear outs, in particular on the epoxy part of the clock. With my palm router and a 45 degrees bearing chamfer bit 1/4 inch, I'm going to shape the clock edges. I switch now to a bigger 45 degrees chamfer bit. This one is 3/8 inch, and I do the second pass. I prefer to do the routing in two passes, increasing the bit size to avoid chipping and tear outs, achieving a much better clean cut, especially on the epoxy clock parts. As you can see, routing the edges in two passes left me with a much better clean cut. The trick is done by removing little material at once. Do the first pass, increase the diameter of the bit for the second pass, results in a clean cut, chipping and tear outs free. I'm going to cut the clock mechanism recess with my palm router and a jig that I just built. A cardboard, I cut a circle with the clock hands dimension. That gives me a reference point where to drill the clock mechanism center hole. With my clock jig in place, I find the center of the clock and let's mark it. My clock mechanism has a diameter of 7.5 millimeters. So I'm going to use a drill bit of 8 millimeter in diameter. Let's drill the center hole. Let's check one more time if everything is in order. Okay, it is. So, let's drill the hole. With my clock mechanism in place, I position the jig. Let's straight it up. Okay, like this. And clamp it down. With my palm router and flush trim bits, I'm going to cut the recess for the clock mechanism. I'm using bits with bearing above the blade. 4 bits in total, all with a diameter of 1/2 inch. Bit with a different length because I must cut a recess 4.5 cm deep. The clock is almost 5 cm thick. I'm cutting the recess, exporting material with a counterclockwise router movement from the edges towards the center. Changing and increasing the bit length, I'm digging my way down until I reach the chosen recess proper depth. It is time to bring back epoxy to its original glossiness. I'm going to sand the clock decreasing the paper grid. I already did 60 grid with the belt sander. From now on, I'm using only orbital sander and I begin with 80 grit paper. I take my time and I sand all the surface, the edges, the other side of course, and I repeat the process for the green clock. 100 grit paper. Hundred eighty grid paper. Hundred twenty grid. 240 280 grit paper. 360 400 500 grid, 600 grid paper, 100% alcohol, I remove all the fine soda dust left by the sand process. And here how it looks like after 600 grit paper. I'm going to complete the sand process using my bare hand, no more orbital sander, and wet sandpaper. I completed the sand process beginning with the 1200 grit. To eliminate all the scratch marks, it's important to do the sanding changing paper grid with the small increments in paper number. Please do not skip any paper grid steps, especially from 60 to 280. Decreasing the paper grid with small decrements is the proper way to eliminate completely visible and fine scratch marks, ending up with a perfect, smooth and glossy epoxy surface. 2000 grit paper. Let's wet it, and with this grid we are going to complete the sand process. With the rubbing alcohol, I'm going to remove all the fine soda dust left by the sanding process. The two clocks are done. In the next video, we are going to apply epoxy final seal coats. Thank you very much for watching, and see you soon. Bye bye.